In this video, we will take you through the essential steps on how to start your experiments with QPatch Compact. Before starting any experiments, please consult our guide for the preparation of cells and solutions and optimization of pipetting. To start your patch clamp experiment, first log on to the screening station software. The pre-flight screen appears. Click the temperature control button to define the target temperature for your experiment. Gently push the Q-plate into the slot on QPatch Compact. The Q-plate pictogram is activated and the screen will now state the barcode. To achieve the correct temperature on the Q-plate, we recommend preheating the instrument with the Q-plate for 1 hour before performing your experiments. From the Q-plate pictogram, select the sites from A to H in which you want to conduct your experiment. The light guidance indicates the corresponding active sites. Select the desired whole cell protocol with which you want to run your experiment. There are a series of standard protocols supplied with your instrument, or you can customize your protocol using the Sophion Analyzer software. You have the option to select the signal conditioning appropriate for your experiment. Identify the type of cell and ion channel you want to record. These lists can be edited in the Sophion Analyzer software. Select the compound you plan to add during your experiment. You can add new compounds or set up a concentration response of the same compound. You can also use the preset buttons to select saline, vehicle, and reference additions. Specify stock concentration, number of dilutions, and dilution factor, and flag it with your desired color. It is also useful to label one button, baseline, to use when running a voltage protocol without adding any liquid. Press the Start button. The instrument starts a hardware check to ensure all hardware modules are operational. Next, add intracellular liquid to the recording sites by reverse pipetting. Press the Done button, and the countdown will indicate when to proceed to the next priming step. Add extracellular liquid to the recording sites by reverse pipetting. Press the Done button. The QPatch Compact proceeds to prime the recording sites. The countdown will indicate the completion of this process. Choose the speed at which you wish to move from one recording site to the next by specifying the dispense delay. Press the Start Countdown button. The light and sound guidance indicate when to dock the pipette and dispense cells. Add the cells site by site as directed by the countdown. Once the live view panel appears, QPatch Compact will position a single cell at each of the recording sites, apply pressure to reach gigohm seal and whole cell configuration. The states are color-coded to easily track the progress of each recording site. The site appears green when the experiment is ready to start. To begin recording after whole cell configuration, you need to establish a baseline. Select the baseline button you added to the compound map and a voltage protocol from the protocol list. Press the Go button, but do not add any liquid at this stage. You can watch the live sweep view and toggle between current and resistance signals to decide when to start your experiment. To measure a pre-compound IV activation, you can select the saline button in the compound map and select any predefined voltage protocol. Add a check mark to repeat the protocol. Press the Go button. To evaluate compounds, make a vehicle-only addition before adding any compound to establish a baseline. Select the compound you want to add. You can apply the compound to a specific site or use the Apply to All option to apply the same compound to all active sites. Press the Go button for each of the active sites and the countdown will indicate when to add a compound to the next site. The timing here is essential for the integrity of the assay and for accurate data analysis. Always remember to add liquids by reverse pipetting. Select your next compound or concentration. Press the Go button. The countdown and the light guidance will indicate when to add the appropriate liquid. QPatch Compact records the current measured after adding the compound. You can view cell parameters such as resistance, pressure, and capacitance in real time simply by clicking the buttons on the right-hand side of the screen. If online cursors have been added when setting up your voltage protocol, you can also view the IT plot as the experiment progresses. You can repeat liquid additions and apply different voltage protocols as many times as needed whilst the recording integrity remains intact. To terminate the recordings, press the End All Experiments button. The data from all recording sites is automatically saved to the onboard database. If you are interested in learning more about how to run a QPatch Compact experiment, please check our website, sophion.com, or send us an email at info@sophion.com. For technical inquiries, please send us an email at qpcsupport@sophion.com. You are also very welcome to visit our labs in Copenhagen, Denmark, Boston, United States, Tokyo, Japan, and Shanghai, China.